10. For we are laborers together with God. God's, in other words, we're on God's team. This is God's idea. This is what God's doing. It has to do with this special position God gave to Paul. This is what he's doing today, and this is his will for our lives today, if we're searching for that will. For we are laborers together with God. Ye are God's husbandry. Ye are God's building, according to the grace of God which is given unto me, Paul said, as a wise master builder, the Greek architekton here, a word that you probably all recognize immediately, architekton. What word do we get from that? Of course, architect. I have laid the foundation, and another buildeth thereon, but let every man take heed how he buildeth thereon. According to the grace of God which is given unto me, Paul said, as a wise master builder, or we could say chief architect of this message God once sent out, this dispensation of grace. You know, when Paul said back in Romans chapter 15 that he would not build upon another man's foundation, that's proof enough that God did not send Paul to build upon or to add further truth to the message of those who preceded Paul. The foundation they laid of Jesus Christ was of Jesus Christ as Messiah to the nation Israel, as the Son of God Messiah promised Israel for the ruling over of that kingdom, that earthly kingdom promised that nation. Paul was sent with a brand new message. Just as he has said, Paul was God's master builder, his chief architect for the age of grace. God gave to the Apostle Paul the ministry, the responsibility of being a channel of God's blueprint, we could say, for what God's doing now. Paul was the channel of God's blueprint for what God's doing now, the chief architect. As another pastor said, that tells me that when we read the Pauline epistles, while they are no more inspired than the rest of the Bible, they are God's instructions directly to me. The rest of God's word should be read, studied, and understood by me, but Paul's writings are God's instruction book to and about me. Couldn't be said any better. Paul, by inspiration of the Holy Spirit, writes, I am the wise master builder. I have laid the foundation. And he goes on to say, let every man take heed how he buildeth thereupon. You see, Paul would not have wanted us to mix the message of the 12 in regard to God's program to and with the nation Israel with the message specifically given him for the Gentiles. Paul was given that brand new revelation. He would not have wanted us to add or mix kingdom truth, as we call it, with the message he dispensed, earthly kingdom truth, we should have said, with the message he dispensed. Then he went to great lengths to separate his ministry from the ministries of those before him. Notice with me Galatians 1, verses 11 and 12. But I certify you, brethren, that the gospel which was preached of me is not after man. You see, some were saying then what some are saying now. Paul was just preaching what the other apostles preached, why they taught it to him. He heard it from them. And so he was just furthering their message. Listen to Paul himself. For I neither received it of man, neither was I taught it, but by the revelation of Jesus Christ. Not Christ in his earthly ministry, Christ from his ascended ministry. Paul goes on to explain in the rest of this chapter that he didn't even go to the other apostles when he first received his revelations from the risen Christ. He conferred not with flesh and blood, is the way he put it. In Galatians 1:17, Paul wrote, neither went I up to Jerusalem to them which were apostles before me, but I went into Arabia and returned again unto Damascus. And when he did go to the 12 to tell them what he was doing, listen to him describe it in Galatians 2:1-2. Then 14 years after, I went up again to Jerusalem with Barnabas and took Titus with me also. And I went up by revelation and communicated unto them that gospel which I preach among the Gentiles. Does that sound like the very same good news the 12 were preaching? He had to communicate unto them. He had to tell them what gospel he was preaching to the Gentiles. Why? Because it was different than the good news they were proclaiming to Israel, or had been proclaiming to Israel. Paul was not preaching what they had been proclaiming. He went up by revelation. In other words, God told him to go. God told him to go explain that gospel which he had been preaching to the Gentiles. Why did God want Paul to go and explain that gospel which he preached? Simple enough. They didn't know anything about it. It's not what they'd been preaching. They didn't know anything about it. Look at it with me. Galatians 2, verse 6. But of these who seem to be somewhat, whatsoever they were, it maketh no matter to me. God hath accepteth no man's person. For they who seem to be somewhat in conference added nothing to me. Now follow me closely here. But contrarywise, when they saw that the gospel to the Gentiles, or is that what it says here? But contrarywise, when they saw that the gospel of the uncircumcision was committed unto me, as, or in the same way that the gospel of the circumcision was committed unto Paul. Huge difference, folks, as I said, difference to Peter, rather. Thank you. Thank you, because some would have gone out totally confused. A huge difference in the gospel of the uncircumcision committed to Paul for the Gentiles and the gospel of the circumcision committed to, not Paul, but Peter for Israel. Huge difference in those words to and of. I hope you've caught that distinction. To, T-O, has more to do with the direction in which the message was sent. That's how most people take this. That isn't Paul's point here. Of, on the other hand, has more to do with whom Paul's gospel concerned. You see, it was a specific gospel, and it belonged specifically to those who had not previously begun under the gospel committed to Peter. Thanks for catching that, by the way. That's quick. That shows me you're on the ball and you're with me right through all of this. The donuts have not put you to sleep this morning. The risen Christ instructed Paul to go up to Jerusalem. He had to go by revelation. Paul didn't want to go on his own. It had to be revealed unto Paul that he was to go, because God wanted Peter, James, and John to recognize that Paul had been divinely chosen to proclaim a special message of good news for the unique age in which we're living. But contrarywise, when they saw that the gospel of, or concerning, belonging to the uncircumcision was committed unto me, as the gospel of, concerning again, or belonging to the circumcision, was unto Peter. For he that wrought effectually in Peter to the apostleship of the circumcision, the same was mighty in me toward the Gentiles. Who is our apostle? The apostle Paul. We have no other apostle, folks, but the apostle Paul. You see, it wasn't just a different people, it was a different message. And God was validating that unique message by sending Paul to proclaim it to those who had been sent to disperse or dispense a different message of good news. Peter's good news was different from Paul's. Let's take it back.